the Federal Reserve System. The IRS is nothing more than a collection agency for the Federal Reserve System. Tazadaq, what's your source of information? Cite your sources. That's program. You'll question me, but you won't question those that's keeping you enslaved. Your taxes, brothers, sisters, go directly to help pay the entrance of the so-called national debt and to enrich the shareholders of the Federal Reserve System. You could like it, understand it, believe it or not. Now, you could go ahead and think it's funny like a damn debtor if you want it. But it's not. Your labor is actually essentially converted into money for their benefit and not yours. Aren't you baffled as to why it seems like the harder you work, the more you strive to work, the less you seem to have? Inflation goes up. The more you work, you get this degree. Or if I get this degree, I'd be all right. And you're still not all right. Why? Because you are a project that they've been working on all of these years. You, 14th Amendment citizen, is a subject, is a slave. You don't have rights, you have privileges. You don't have rights. You relinquish your rights in exchange for privileges, and now you're wondering why all of these things are actually happening to you. You know that something's wrong, but you can't put your hands on exactly what's wrong. Something's wrong. Then you're going over YouTube and something inspired you. And I can tell you what it was. It was the spirit of the Most High that inspired you to click on Tazadaq's video. And since you clicked on one of my videos, it seems as if you couldn't stop. You couldn't stop. Why? It's not because I'm entertaining you. I'm not giving you something that's entertaining you. I'm strengthening your mind. Because I'm giving you right knowledge. I'm giving you truth. I'm giving you that which your soul yearns for. Right knowledge. Truth. I'm not advocating overthrow a government. I'm advocating liberation of your thinking. I'm advocating freedom. And anyone that doesn't want you to travel down that path of freedom is a wolf that intends to make you his prey. Are you gonna continue to be a sheep led to the slaughter? It's a question. You could lead a sheep just about anywhere. But me, I'm a revolutionary. I fight for that which is right, even if that requires me to give my life. And if you want to behave like a damn debtor, if you want to come to me with arguments, don't bring that madness over here. You're not welcome to this channel. If you want to come by and give the video a damn thumbs down, well, to hell with you. To hell with you. You go over there with the rest of the damn debtors in the Matrix. Go ahead and spend $150,000 in your so-called higher education. And then you finish the rest of your life in misery and stress, trying to figure out how you're going to pay off this student loan before you perish, which you're never going to pay off. But there's remedy. But you're not interested in the remedy because you're a program, because you suffer from the dishonest theory. You cannot think beyond your program. You're caught up into the Matrix. And the few people of Zion that's trying to lead you right, you keep fighting. You're fighting your liberators. You're fighting those that's trying to liberate your thinking. Because you are a slave. And the best kind of slave there is those of you that don't even know that you're a damn slave. You damn debtor, shut up and listen. You need to hear this. And Brother Tor Mike, keep doing what you're doing in DC, King. Keep doing what you're doing. out. Tariq, keep doing what you doing. In Atlanta, King, keep doing what you doing, man. And everybody out there that's standing up for justice, so it won't be, you know, just us. Teach someone else. Open up your mind. Open up your thinking. Overcome your fears. Because fear is the only thing that's preventing you from being the person that you want to be, that you're supposed to be. It's your fear. It's your fear and it's your negative thinking. But if you could overcome your fear, if you could push past that fear, then you're going to see I'm giving you right knowledge and you're going to get on board. You're going to get on deck. But you have to stop succumbing to your fear. What are you afraid of? The very thing that you're afraid of is going to keep you where you are. Next year, you're going to be singing the same old song. Old Tazadaq, I want to become a secure party creditor. I just don't have the money. Well, go out and sell fucking snow cones. It's 106 degrees outside right now. Go and sell some fucking snow cones. Excuse my French, but stop making excuses, man. Because excuses is what renders you.
Attention retirees. If you're willing to be at your computer from 9 a.m. to 10:45 a.m.
A failure. Do what you gotta do as long as you're not causing injury to another man or woman or causing mischief in a contract or hurting someone else. That's the common law. That's the law of the Most High. You know, don't violate someone else. But don't tell me you can't. Don't tell me you can't. Don't talk to me like a damn debtor talking about what you could have done. Because you're gonna be singing that same song for the rest of your life. Because I grew up around debtors like that. Oh yeah, man, I could have been this. Or I used to be that. Don't tell me about how you used to be. Who are you now? What are you doing right now? I don't want to hear about how you used to be. How great you used to be. I used to work out, Tazadaq. I was really skilled. Yeah, but where are you now? And would have, could have, should have never makes it into the arena. Man, I respect the man that tried and failed more than someone talking about what they could have done. What you should have done. Because saying what you should have done, you would never make it into the arena. But if you fell, at least you tried. At least you got something. But if you ain't never put forth no effort, then you've lost from the start. So get your mind right, young king. Get your mind right, young princess. Get your minds right. The only person, the only man, the only woman that you need to compare yourself to is you. Don't compare yourself to Tazadaq. Don't compare yourself to Brother Larry. Don't compare yourself, oh, well, he's doing it this way. Because that's what weak people do. They look outside of themselves to some third party or some third entity and compare themselves to that. And so they may, and if you do that, you may not be able to measure your growth. Where were you yesterday? How great were you yesterday? Are you better today? And that's what you got to strive to do. You got to strive to be better today than you was yesterday. Because each second, second by second, you lose a part of who you're supposed to be. So what are you waiting for to become a secured party creditor? Email me now. Creditors, debtors, contracts at yahoo.com. Stop making excuses. 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 You'll never make it into the arena with your hands held high as champion with excuses. They never make it into the arena. It's the person that fell, got back up, fell, got back up, fell, got back up. That's how winning is done. You keep trying. You keep pushing. You push through the pain. You push through the difficult times. So, brothers and sisters, I hope to see you at the seminar in Atlanta, Tucker, Georgia. August the 19th. It's getting close. If you ain't at the seminar, then you're not on debt. Stop making excuses. And if you do show up, you're going to get a wealth of information. No, get from this moment on right now, you need to make a commitment, not to Tazadaq, but to yourself, that you're going to change your life. Stop eating a lot of bad food. Try to eat healthy. Stop eating these damn processed foods. Stop eating red meat. If you want to go even further, become like me. Stop eating meat altogether. Get off of that. I'm not telling you that it's a must, but you got to have your mind, your body, and your spirit in unison. 100% organic. It's not just a shirt. I'm 100% organic. I'm real. So brothers and sisters, all of your problems is from the infliction of commerce. Purchase my book. My new book was just released. Commercial Warfare, We the People versus Despotism, second edition, 266 pages. That I named that book that for a reason. Because this is a despotic de facto that is manipulating the people. The people do not realize that you are actually damn slaves. You're debtors. And you get angry with men like me to take a stand. You damn debtor. I might lose my life for teaching people this. Yeah, you want to argue. You want to argue. You want to get into arguments. It's a debtor. I don't have any space for debtors in my life. I'm a creditor. A secured party creditor. And brothers and sisters, if you want to soar to new heights, you must eliminate all of the debtors from your life. I don't give a damn if they're family members or whoever. If they're thinking it's like a debtor, they're going to bring you down. Negative and positive cannot occupy the same space at once. Darkness and lightness cannot occupy the same space at once. Eliminate the debtors from your life. See you at the seminar, August 19th, from 12 to 6 p.m., Atlanta, Georgia. If you're not there, then you're not on deck. Now let's give you some more right knowledge. Deprogram Enlightener. Deprogram Enlightener.
Your time, young boy. You're not ready to learn about the real past.
Yeah, that's right.